Hi everyone and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about another software update, as this time it was Fitbit who delivered on their promise and released the new Fitbit OS 5.1 for the Sense and the Versa 3 smartwatches a couple of days ago. As I said it in my original review, we were expecting this update and now we talk through the new features one by one. First, there is the voice assistant. So far you could only use Amazon Alexa on the watch, but now you can choose the Google Assistant as well instead. If you want to use it, then all you have to do is activate it in the Fitbit smartphone app and then you are good to go. The Amazon Alexa has also received an update, so now it can speak responses back to you using the built-in speaker. Is there going to be any fog tomorrow?
Tomorrow in Air Square, it looks like there will be partly sunny weather, with a high of 7 degrees Celsius and a low of 3 degrees.
However, the Google Assistant will only display responses on the screen. Is there going to be any fog tomorrow? So you get the information on screen, and that's pretty much it. You can also use the built-in mic to respond to messages as long as you are on Android. Another new feature is that now you can take phone calls on the watch itself. Let's see how it works. And there we go. I'm just answering it on the watch. Hello there.
Hello, how are you doing?
Good now. You know what? I'm actually talking through the watch now and I can hear you from the watch as well. How can you hear me? Is it clear enough?
I can hear you pretty well, yeah.
That's great. Let's see if I can bring up the volume a little bit. Yeah. And I can even mute myself if I needed to, or bring up the keypad, or put the phone call back on the phone. Okay, honey, you know what? Actually, that's all I needed. Thank you for your help. And see you later.
No problem. See you, bye.
Bye-bye. Next up is the updated blood oxygen saturation feature. So far, you could only get an SpO2 reading at night if you were using the one and only compatible watch face. From now on, the readings will happen automatically regardless of what watch face you use, and you already have a few new watch faces in the app gallery which will display your SpO2 values as well, and a few more coming before the end of this year. And last but not least, there are the advanced sleep analytics, which used to be available for premium members only, but now it's all there by default for everyone without having to pay €9 or dollars a month. So there we go, these are all the new features of the Fitbit OS 5.1. It's a pretty substantial upgrade if you ask me, which made both the Versa 3 and the Sense an even better value for the money. If you'd like to see similar videos in the future, then please give this one a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, see you next time.